wait outside.
Welcome, welcome. I hadn't had customers since 2 days ago. We were wondering if you had any warm clothing and oxygen tanks.
Of course you do, and you'll also need this.
Don't mind me asking, but what in tarnations is that?
This is a gamma bag. It's very useful for when your party gets hape.
Hape? What is that?
It stands for high altitude pulmonary edema. It's a sickness developed from the lack of air pressure.
Okay, but back to what I was saying. We'll also need transportation, other supplies such as food, tent, you know, the usual.
Don't fret, I have it all here. I'll give the scamble bag to you along with the clothing, oxygen tanks, and transportation all for just $5,000.
Aye, does that come with a good guy discount?
No.
Ah, no worries, I'll just charge the World Magazine.
Wait, before you go, you'll need a guide.
But that's why
we'll let you take care of the booby traps.
Say, what's your name again?
I didn't say. My name is Sanya Dorhi. In your language, it means Thundering Lion.
Sai, aren't you one of those Sherpa guides that live here?
Actually, that's what I'm doing. I'm not working here. I do know the mountains very well and could be of assistance to you. Where are you going?
Right here.
I would have to say that that X is somewhere on the north slope of Lhotse. I would say that the best way to get there is through the West Quim. Say, what is this on the back?
It's from Marco Polo. It says,
you have surpassed the first part of the test, but can you handle the rest?
Seek the golden sword on a place so high that it will take you days to make the climb. When you reach a temple that's sore worn and old, make your way inside. But be careful. Avoid the traps and don't get frostbitten with the cold. Talk about poetic.
We'll make our way to the West Quim once everything is ready.
But I happen to know the West Quim is far away from here. How do you suppose we'll get there?
Easy. By hot air balloon.
So you sure we can find a Sherpa guide?
Yes, I'm sure.
I don't like this side of town. We might get shot at.
Don't worry. This is probably the safest place in the world.
I put snow in my mouth so he doesn't see my breath. Gently, gently, I squeeze the trigger.
Watch out!
Dang it. I missed. Again.
What's the matter with you? Is audio insane?
That's none of your business.
Yes, it is. Now answer the question.
Okay. I'm not mad. I'm just hunting down a wild yeti.
Okay. He is insane.
No. I really saw one. It was during the famous Swiss expedition.
The one where everyone died.
Yes, that's the one. The paper said it was hape, but it's really a vicious yeti. I was the only one who survived, but I lost my leg and my assistant, Mr. Stubb, in the process. See? Here's my peg leg.
But that's only a myth.
Well, you're wrong. I'm determined to find him. And when I do, I'll avenge my leg and the death of every member of the party and mount his furry white head over my tent for everyone to see.
Why do you want to do that?
I hate the furry mongrel.
What happens if he gets the wrong one?
That will be just mistaken identity, but I will get him.
Look, it's Johnny. We need to stop him.
I've got a plane at the airport. Let's go.
Get out of the car. Into the trunk, schnell, schnell. There's the airport.
It's right down this road.
I got ya.
Feel like I'm in an episode of the Flintstones.
Patrick, shut up. We made it.
Where will we sit?
Just make do.
curious, Doctor. What do you know about Mount Everest?
Well, Dan, the region above 26,200 feet is called the Death Zone because a human could only survive in this region without oxygen tanks for a few days. But that does not mean nothing can survive in the region. Previous expeditions have noticed small insects dwelling in the snow around Camp 5. And did you know that when standing on top of Mount Everest, you're 5 miles closer to the sun than you are at sea level?
Amazing! But it sure is stifling in this basket.
Why don't you hold on to the rigging? It's much safer.
You said something about the rigging being safe, Mike.
It's just that I didn't see that one coming. What hit me?
I don't know. Whatever it was, we didn't do anything.
I think I found what startled Harry, and it's not good.
Too windy over here. I get bugs in my teeth.
Shut up. Just let me finish off thunder.
What hit?
Here are some patches. When you all have to go topside and fix the balloon.
I've got them.
Oh, they got us. We're gonna die!
Sandu Death Patrick, shut up!
This will teach him not to mess with John Thunder.
I've got an idea! How tight can the biplane turn?
I've seen these things a flight before, and let me tell you, their turns are pretty tight.
I lost the flare gun!
And if we put another hole in this balloon, we're goners!
Wait! How many flares do we have?
I don't know. About 10 at the most.
Harry, I will need your shotgun.
What for?
I'm going to put a flare into your shotgun and fire it into their engine.
By crikey, that'll never work. We'll just ruin the shotgun.
Trust me. It'll work.
Die!
Was our last time, Patrick? Shut up!
It worked!
I can see base camp in the distance. We'll land there and make our way back foot.
My plane. Look what they did to my plane.
Who cares about the plane? We just need to get to the base camp.
He's right, you know.
But that was my brother's.